What's up, YouTube? Robbie Vapes back again, and today we have another giveaway going on, so stay tuned. That's right, today we have a giveaway for the Z-Pal Coral Tank. If you don't remember which tank this was actually a tank that was capable of going up to 200 watts, give or take. Great tank, it's honestly my favorite tank. It is the closest thing to a dripper in the tank form I have found to date. It's a high powered tank, you're gonna need a high powered device to get this thing done. Here it is here. I've got two of these for giveaway. They sent a couple of these over to me just for you guys, just because they liked the video and they wanted to send me a couple more of these. These will be going out to you, the viewers. So I have two of these up for grabs right here and just cannot wait to pay back my viewers for that because you guys are amazing. So the rules for the giveaway are very simple. You must be at least 18 years or older, depending on where you are. Of course, I'm going to go by based on what the legal vaping age is in your area. So I will be checking that out. Make sure you are the legal age. Second, of course, you must be a subscriber of mine. And third, you must leave one and only one comment down below on this video. Now, the winner will be announced once I hit 3,500 subscribers. I am just short of 2,900 subscribers right now. So we are almost there. I'm growing like crazy right now. I cannot thank you guys enough for that. So once we hit 3,500 subscribers, I will announce the giveaway winners and we'll do a quick YouTube randomizer thing, randomize comments and pick out two winners from there. Moving on from there, as you may have noticed, my background has changed. It is no longer those two white ugly shelves. Instead, I've replaced it with a really nice computer desk, which is where I'm doing all my editing now. And of course, the really ugly corkboard. The reason for the setup mainly was because I have my computer desk on this desk that I use here for reviews, and it was just a pain in the ass having to move it off, move it on every time I did reviews and recordings. So to make it a little bit easier on myself, what I've done is move the computer to its designated shelf, and we actually have a computer desk back there with the computer on it. You will see a different change of view for Project Fog tonight. Instead of it being this way, it'll actually be going this way. Now, if you don't know what Project Fog is, it is a collaboration effort between myself, Hank Vapes, and Vape and Heathen, plus some special guests usually on the shows. The show airs every Sunday at 8 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Make sure to check it out tonight. I'm sure we'll have a ton of fun tonight. It's a live show. We always get a little bit rowdy on there, so we're going to enjoy it a little bit more and just have fun with it. Anyways, guys, moving on from there. I know it's been about a week since I posted my last video, and I do want to apologize for that. The reason why is I want to take about a week off just to spend some time with some friends and family. Obviously, doing all these videos for you guys, it's great. I love it, don't get me wrong. But I needed some time to catch up with my friends and family who I haven't seen in a little while. Obviously, being on YouTube, it takes up a little bit of your time, you know, between editing, recording, getting things together, you know, looking out for reviews, using products over and over again. It's just one of the things that takes up a lot of time. People may not realize how much time it actually takes up. So I just took that week off just to kind of catch up with people and see how they're doing, spend some time with some friends I haven't seen in a little while, and really just catch up with everybody. So that's why I've been away for about a week now. But anyways, guys, I am back now, so that's the important thing. I do have a ton of reviews coming your way very shortly, including the vapes and Ceramica, a bunch of stuff from Anokin that I'm super excited to show off to you guys. The DNA three-way has had a little bit of a hitch in it, actually, which is very interesting. My VT200 that I had decided to shit the bed on me, and it's now not even working. It's basically a brick. Thankfully, they will be exchanging it, so that is a good sign, but it may take a couple weeks to get that VT200 back by the time we ship off the bricked one and I get the new one back in. I actually, just a little quick note, nothing happened to it. Didn't drop, didn't fall. I didn't let it go too low. In fact, it actually had about 33% battery life left at the time it died, and it just basically shut off and would not turn back on no matter what. I tried hooking up to the eScribe software. I tried turning it on through a charger. Nothing. It was completely blank screen, done for. Now, of course, the biggest reason why that throws a hitch into things is because that was actually going to be the front runner for the DNA three-way, and it's interesting to know that it did brick out, which kind of makes me a little bit hesitant to put it in the top now. I'll have to be doing a whole new series of tests just to try and figure out which one of these three devices I will recommend for you, the viewers. And honestly, guys, so far, the DNA 200 chip, just a little spoiler alert, I'm kind of disappointed with it in general. I really am. There's so much customization to it. It's a great chip. It has so many features, so many things to offer. And yet all three of these devices I've actually had issues with. Whether it be me or someone else, I've had issues with it, but I should say I've seen firsthand that these all have issues. The VT200 seemed to be the one that got away from it all, but now that it's bricked, I mean, that just adds one more issue to the mix. On top of that, the Wismec Reload DNA 200, I had someone else who bought one, and they actually, within the first day, got a message on the screen saying return to researcher, which is just mind-boggling. But anyways, so the Wismec DNA 200 has had issues, and the Vapor Shark, although it hasn't had any of those issues, it's had other issues which seem to be ongoing, which is, of course, when I lock it, for some reason, if I put it in my pocket, if I put it in my backpack, it will unlock itself and begin to auto-fire, which is not a good thing. Now, the benefit to this is that it does have a shut-off feature, which is very good. If it didn't have that shut-off feature, it would be super dangerous, but it looks to shut off after a certain amount of time. I don't know how much time, but I can confirm on two occasions I had locked it, either put it in my pocket or my backpack, and it had unlocked itself and began auto-firing for a long amount of time. Both of those times, I triple-checked to make sure it was locked before putting it away, and of course, it just wasn't enough, and somehow, I don't know if it's a button protruding or something like that, but something is happening to unlock this device and then cause it to auto-fire, which is not good and not safe at all. I've probably burned through 3 or 4 coils now on this thing because it's fired it to the point where the cotton turns black and gets burnt, which is not good, but thankfully it didn't cause any fires or anything like that. But it's one thing to know that after the last time this happened, I actually learned my lesson. Since then, I've actually been taking off the tanks from the device itself and then putting them separately in the backpack or in my pocket, just to keep it safe like that. I don't want to risk it again. The last time it happened was in my car. I basically walked into my car after maybe 10 minutes of going grocery shopping or whatever, and just had pure smell of burning in my car. Thankfully, it had shut off by itself, which was huge, and that's how I learned it actually has an auto shut off feature. The first time it happened, it was in my pocket. I was walking around somewhere, and all of a sudden I smell burning. Sure enough, open my pocket, cloud of smoke comes out, and burnt another coil that way. But like I said, if you are going to use one of these, the Vapor Shark seems to have an auto fire issue. At least mine does. I don't know if all of them have it. I don't know if just some of them have it, but keep in mind, make sure when you are storing this, don't just lock it. Take off the tank from the device and store them separately to avoid any kind of auto firing from happening. So I just wanted to put those warnings out there for you guys. The DNA 200 chip does not seem to be perfect by any stretch, and it's kind of expected because it is still a new chip. But the problem is, because you're paying so much for these devices that have these chips in them, it's a little bit of a risk, just a heads up, it is a little bit of a risk to go out and purchase one of these things when they are having these kind of issues that we're experiencing. Now, like I said, I was lucky enough to have the VT200 exchange for another one, but I don't know if everyone's going to do that. That might not apply to every single person who has this issue. So just be wary that if you do get something, you do run the risk of having a $200 device turn into a brick or a paperweight at any time for no reason whatsoever. As far as the Vapor Shark goes, again, if you're going to use a Vapor Shark, take the tank off from it or take the RDA off from it. Make sure it's separate from it when you are storing it. Even if the device is locked, it still runs the risk of unlocking itself and to the point where it'll burn your cotton and potentially go even further than that depending on how long it auto-fires for. Anyway, so I just wanted to put that warning out there. I don't want you guys spending your hard-earned money on these devices to have something happen like it bricks out, turns into a paperweight, or even worse, potentially causes a fire. All right, so we've talked about the DNA 200s, we've talked about the new background, we've talked about things to come, we've talked about the giveaway. So what do you say we end the video here? Just want to thank everybody again for all of your support. I cannot tell you how much it means to me. I am growing at an awesome rate right now and just owe it all to you, the viewers, for that support. So with that being said, guys, that will end the video here. Thank you all for watching. And of course, until next time, YouTube, happy vaping.